Okay, good day everyone. Welcome to Easy English Trial Class titled Fun Grammar Class Playing at Bikini Bottom with SpongeBob. Okay, so in Indonesia there is a famous saying known as tak kenal maka tak sayang. So let me introduce myself. My name is Miss Safira. You can call me Miss Fira or Miss Safira. And I'm going to be your instructor today, and again, it is a pleasure to extend a very welcome to all of you here today. So, before I move on to the lesson, we will talk about some basic class rules, okay, that you all need to pay attention on, okay? Okay, so here are some basic class rules, okay? I need you to pay attention on this so that we can enjoy the lesson comfortably as well as effectively. And, you know, like, so just, we are all in line, okay? We are all together. All right, so please, for the first time, please turn on your camera, okay? So that I can see you, so that I can talk to you, and I know that you are there. And there are going to be a lot of interaction in this class. So yeah, it's better to see each other, okay? So please make sure that you have turned the camera on. Okay, and second, it is very important to be respectful to each other, okay? So while I'm talking, please don't disturb each other, don't chat unnecessarily, and pay attention to the lesson so we can learn together effectively. And if you have any questions, you can just ask me or click the raise hand button first. And last but not least, please be active, okay? And don't be shy, because we are all here learning together. I'm a learner as well, okay? So don't be shy, don't be nervous, don't be afraid to make mistakes. And, you know, like mistakes are a part of your learning as well. Practice makes better. So instead of being quiet, just be active and be confident, all right? Okay, jadi kita pede aja ya dulu teman-teman. So, I have mentioned the rules and now I would like to check whether you have understood my rules and whether you are here listening to me. So, could you please give me a thumbs up or raise your hand through the reaction box? I would like to know if you have understood the rules. Could you please give your reset? Okay, Mariam raised hand. What about the others? All right, I see some people raise their hand. I need more to make sure that you are listening. Okay. All right, so I assume that you have learned the rules, you have understood the rules, and in Easy English, we usually start the class by playing an easy game. So Easy English, easy game, and easy learning. So let's start by playing some game, an easy game together, shall we? Okay. Now, today's game is called Word Search, okay? With the theme of SpongeBob SquarePants. And actually, it is pretty simple to play. So what you have to do right now is, okay, you have to find these words, okay? Down here, find this on this, find the on the box, okay? Try to find it, and I want you to, kita cepet-cepet ya jawabnya ya, harus cepet-cepet, jadi kita buru-buru nih, siapa yang cepat nanti you can get a chance to get an interesting prize. Okay, can we start now? 1, 2, 3, be active and follow the rules, all right? Okay, so what we are going to learn today is actually a very fun topic, you know, and I'm glad that you all had fun in the beginning. Now, I'm pretty sure that all of you here know the story of SpongeBob SquarePants, or Bikini Bottom, where SpongeBob and their friends live, or maybe you have ever known or watched this show. Okay, well, today is a very special day because you are going to read a short story about SpongeBob SquarePants and his friends, as well as you are going to learn grammar through the story. Trust me, it will be fun. Okay, right, listen everyone. So, one fine day in Bikini Bottom, there lived SpongeBob and his friends. One day, there was a new huge mall in Bikini Bottom. SpongeBob became really excited, and he became really excited to visit the mall because he saw a lot of people went there, and he became really excited to shop. So, not to mention, he brought his funny bestie, Patrick Star, to accompany him shopping. So he said, "Patrick, we should explore the new mall together." And then Patrick, of course, became really happy, and he said, "I'm all set in my body, so let's go." So after that, they went to the mall together. So when they arrive at the mall, they look around. They look around one by one, and they were so surprised to see how huge the mall is. Many people coming there to shop, many interesting stores to visit, and feeling awesome, Patrick happily screamed, "Buddy, this is gonna be our best day ever." Then they started visiting the stores one by one, okay? And suddenly, there was this one store, okay? One store that really caught SpongeBob's attention. He really liked the store, and it is a clothing store, and it gives a 50% discount if SpongeBob could reach a certain amount of payment. Jadi guys, SpongeBob bisa dapat diskon 50% nih kalau dia bisa beli barang yang mencapai harga tertentu. Okay, so of course this made SpongeBob really happy and interested. So he started looking around, okay, dia cari-cari dulu, and then he found a best cloth to buy, and tada! Okay, he found this red cloth and screamed excitedly, "Oh my God, this is perfect for Abe, okay? And I will surely get the 50% discount if I can buy this amazing clothes." Of course, he was very excited and interested to buy. So feeling confident with the clothes, he walked to the cashier to purchase it. But however, when he was about to pay in the cashier, it turns out that he still had to pay fully because he didn't reach that minimum payment. Jadi ternyata dia belum dapat diskon nih. Jadi dia harus beli lagi gitu kan. Belum dapat diskonnya. And of course, it made SpongeBob sad and regretted his decision. So he walked out from the store, and then he sadly yelled, "Oh no, clothes." And then Patrick was curious, "What's wrong, buddy?" And SpongeBob said, "Well, I will tell you why." And then SpongeBob told Patrick what happened. So after hearing the story, Patrick gave a belated advice for SpongeBob. "Well, you should have bought two clothes, buddy." And then it made SpongeBob confused. But what should I do with two clothes, Patrick? Won't it be wasteful?" And then Patrick calmly replied, "Well, you could have given one to me, or you could have just sold that one with the original price to other people." And then hearing this advice, SpongeBob think, "Wait, that's not a bad idea." Okay, so that's the short story. Okay, from the story, we can learn that before we buy something, we must check it carefully, okay? But not only that, yeah, guys, moreover, from the story of SpongeBob and Patrick, we can also learn about grammar law. Do you want to know? Okay, so if you notice the dialogue between SpongeBob and Patrick, we can learn that we can use should have when we regretted our decision in the past. We can also say should have when we want to give advice, even though it's already late. And third, we can use could have when we want to show options that we didn't choose in the past. Okay, so let me get deeper to the examples, okay? Okay, so if you notice back then, we can say should have when we regretted our decision in the past. Remember when SpongeBob said, "Oh no, I should have bought two clothes." It means that he expressed his regret, okay? Jadi dia kecewa nih. Nah, kalau kita kecewa, kita tuh bisa menggunakan should have. Okay, we can use should have to express our regret ketika kita kecewa. Misalnya nih, kalian lagi keluar gitu ya, lagi keluar terus kalian lupa nih bawa masker. Nah, nanti pulang-pulang kalian sakit gitu. And you can simply say like, "Oh no, I should have brought my mask," gitu. Jadi should have to express your regret. Kalau kamu kecewa, just say should have. Okay? But not only that, okay? We can also say should have. Okay, when we want to give a late advice, remember when Patrick advised SpongeBob, he said, "Well, you should have bought two clothes, buddy." See, "Well, you should have bought two clothes, buddy." So, Patrick mencoba mengasih advice nih, walaupun nasihatnya tuh sudah telat gitu ya, but we can say, we can use should have to say with that, to say like that, okay? Contohnya nih, okay, let me give another examples. Misalnya kita lagi exams, ternyata ada teman kalian yang tidak belajar nih pas lagi mau ujian, and he end up getting a bad score. Kalian bisa nasihat kasih nasihat dia dengan bilang, "Oh, you should have studied more instead of playing," like that. Okay, now could have. Okay, now Patrick used could have to show options that SpongeBob didn't choose in the past. Jadi kita bisa pakai could have untuk memberitahu pilihan yang kita belum pilih di masa lalu. Misalnya tadi SpongeBob itu belum sempat pilih buat beli satu lagi, atau dia belum sempat kepikir untuk jual bajunya. So Patrick said, "Well, you could have given one to me, or you could have just sold that one with the original price to other people," like that. Okay. Okay, now what about trying to have some practice? Okay, let's practice it together. 1 minute.
Okay. Why does the chair is like that?
I'm sorry?
But why does the table look like for the baby?
Oh, it's like for a baby. Yeah, you're right. I don't know, but it's in the cartoon. Okay. Now, sorry, is the screen share moving? Wait. Okay. Now, let's take a look at the first practice, okay? SpongeBob threw a party, okay? But the party became boring because he only invited 3 people to the party. And he suddenly become he suddenly regretted his decision. He said, "Oh no, Patrick, we blah 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 invited more people to our party." And it expressed past regret. "Yeah, buddy, you only invited 3 people and this is boring. I was worried that we won't have enough room for everyone," he said. "So, could you guess what should we fill in there?" Okay, should it be could have or should have?
Should have.
Okay.
Should have.
Very nice. Could you tell me why?
Because it's past regret.
Because it's past regret. Exactly. Okay. Let's see for the correct answer. Yes, you're right. It should be should have. "Oh no, Patrick. We should have invited so many people to our party." Very nice. Good job, everyone. Now, who wants to try to be a volunteer to act like to act as SpongeBob and Patrick, and you can read the dialogue?
Me.
Who is it? Jocelyn, yeah.
Jacqueline.
I'm sorry.
Miss Iwan.
Jocelyn.
Okay, who wants to try first? Okay, give me two names first.
Jovian.
Okay, what about Jocelyn and Jovian for the first, and then after that, the others can try as well. Okay, Jocelyn, who do you want to be?
I want to be SpongeBob.
Very nice. What about Jovian?
SpongeBob.
Oh, the other should be Patrick. Okay, who wants to be Patrick? One should be SpongeBob and the other should be Patrick. Okay, let me just decide, yeah. Jocelyn, you will be SpongeBob, and Jovian, yeah, you will be Patrick. Okay, can we start now?
Okay. "Oh no, Patrick, we should have invited so many people to our party."
"Yeah, buddy, you only invited 2 people and this is boring."
"I was worried that we won't have enough room for everyone."
Very good. Okay. Thank you. Now, who wants to try?
Jacqueline with?
Jetrin with? Okay. You should have a partner. Who wants to be Jetrin's partner? Can I have, Mariam raised her hand. Okay. Mariam, wait. Mariam, could you please read the dial? Could you please be Patrick and Jetris, yeah? You should be SpongeBob.
Okay. "Oh no, Patrick. We should have invited so many people to our party."
"Yeah, buddy, you only invite 2 people and this is boring."
"I was worried that we would have enough room for everyone."
Okay, very nice. Okay, great job, everyone. Now we move on to the next practice, yeah? And you can also, try to practice the dialogue as well. Okay. All right. SpongeBob, blah, 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 wore his mask when he went to public places. "Poor my little buddy, he is ill now." and SpongeBob became really sick. I'm so sick. So what do you think?
Could have.
It should be okay. Let's see the answer first. Okay, let's see the answer
could
first.
Could have.
Okay, nice try. That's okay, but it should be should have because it is a past advice. Okay, remember. SpongeBob was sick, and then Patrick remembered, oh, it is because he forgot to bring his mask. So, SpongeBob should have brought his mask when he went to public places. Poor my little buddy, he is ill now. Okay, very great. Now, who wants to try to be SpongeBob and Patrick? Okay, remember, SpongeBob is sick, so you have to act like you are sick. Okay, you have to cough.
Catherine.
Okay, those who haven't tried, yeah, I want those who haven't tried. Okay, those who haven't tried first, or let me just choose one name. Okay, who wants to try?
Jovian.
Jovian. Okay, Jovian. Could Jethrin. You please? Jethrin. Jovian and Jethrin. Okay, sorry. Jovian, who would you like to be?
Patrick.
And then Jovian. Jethris.
SpongeBob.
Okay, so remember if you're SpongeBob, you need to cough, yeah? Okay, just let's start now from SpongeBob.
SpongeBob should have brought his mask when he went to public place. Poor my little buddy, he's ill now.
Okay, SpongeBob.
I am so sick.
Okay, that's nice. Thank you. Anyone else wants to try?
Jocelyn.
Okay, Jocelyn again. And I need to choose one name, okay? Can I choose... Where? Hafiz. Can I choose Hafiz? Hafiz, are you there? Okay, Hafiz is not here. What about Najla? Najla and yeah, Najla and Alia maybe. Okay. Ayo, so don't be shy, yeah, guys. Yeah, don't be shy. We are all learning together, so it's okay to make mistakes. Just Jocelyn. Jocelyn, you need to choose one partner. Please choose one. And please choose those who haven't. Those who haven't tried. Those who haven't tried.
What did you say before? Repeat again.
Yes. Okay. Jocelyn, you will be one of the speaker, but you have to choose your partner and you have to choose from the one that haven't tried speaking.
I don't know.
Oh, you don't know? Okay. Can I have Alia Zahwa? Alia Zahwa or Aisha and Anissa?
They're all just close their camera. I cannot see.
Sorry, wait. Yeah. What about Najla? Najla. Do you want to try Najla? Najla and Jocelyn. One should be Patrick and one should be SpongeBob.
Can I be Patrick?
Oh, you want to be Patrick, Jocelyn? Okay. Okay, Najla is here. Okay, just let's start from SpongeBob, yeah? So Najla will be SpongeBob.
I'm so sick.
SpongeBob.
SpongeBob should have brought this max when he went to public places. Poor my little buddy. He's ill now.
Very good. Okay. Okay, I'm glad that you can speak it very clearly, very nice, and I'm so surprised that you can understand the difference of should have and could have. Now, what about let's try some exercise and let's see whether you can answer it or not. Okay, let me share my screen first again. And for this one, I want you to reply me through the chat privately. Can you? Okay, just text me privately on the chat meeting. Okay?
Okay.
All right, very good. Okay, so there are 5 questions, okay? And you need to answer one by one and make sure you have understood it. Okay, if you don't, just please ask me. And if you can guess it correctly, you get a chance to win an interesting prize. Okay, what about number 2?
Should have.
Could you tell me why?
Could have. Because it's a packet device.
Yeah. Wait, let me annotate first. Okay, for the first one, it should have. Okay, for the second one, it should have because it expresses past advice. Very nice. Okay, now we go on to number 3.
Should have.
Okay, so I heard someone say could have, someone say should have.
Should have.
Calm down. The correct answer is could have because it shows options. Yes, it shows options that we didn't choose in. I'm sure all of you here, like Ka Andre, Ka Yudi are feeling proud as well because you guys are so interactive and you are so courageous. So that's a very good job. Keep it up, okay? So wait, let me get back to the story, guys. We haven't finished the story yet. Let me just get back for it. Wait a minute.
Okay. Why we should finish with what story? What story?
Still the same story, SpongeBob and Patrick. But wait, okay. Do you know what SpongeBob finally decided for the cloth?
He's not gonna buy it.
What?
He's gonna buy it.
Did he buy it 1, 2, or did he sell it? What do you think?
He buy two.
Okay, let's see. 1, 2.
Shirt.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Yay, right. They bought he decided to negotiate with the store and then he bought 2 clothes for him and for Patrick so that he can celebrate the 8th together. Very nice. Okay, so I think that's all for the lesson, and I'm very glad that you all did amazingly. You can understand the lesson very effectively, very comfortably, and enthusiastically. And I'm so proud that all of you are so brave. Okay, for the answers before, okay, that, okay. For you guys who haven't, answered the question, that's okay. But for you who have answered, our committee will just contact you for the prize. Okay, so let's just wait. Now, I will hand over to Kak Erik, yeah, for further information. Yes.
Thank you, okay. Kak Safira. Okay. Gimana teman-teman tadi? Seru kan belajar grammarnya? Jadi belajar grammar itu kita nggak cuma teori doang kan. Tadi ketemu SpongeBob, ketemu Patrick. Jadi teman-teman, adik-adik bisa belajar grammar dengan lebih menyenangkan. Jadi semua udah tahu kan, could have sama should have. Tadi seru-seru ya Kak Safira ya. Adik-adik aktif semua untuk menjawab quiz-quiz dari Kak Safira. Jadi nanti Kak Safira sudah melihat jawaban dari adik-adik. Nanti adik-adik yang benar semua akan mendapatkan hadiah khusus dari Easy English. Nanti akan dihubungi oleh tim admin yang hubungin bapak, ayah, bunda dari adik-adik sekalian. Nah, sekarang Kak Erik ini mau mengundang Kak Yudi untuk membantu ngasih tahu nih ke adik-adik dan ayah, bunda, program-program apa aja sih yang ada di Easy English selain grammar tadi. Silakan Kak Yudi, Kak Erik undang untuk menjelaskan program dari Easy English.
Okay, thank you Kak Erik, thank you Miss Safira, and thank you for all the participants. Terima kasih adik-adik sudah datang. Seru nggak tadi sama Kak Safira, sama Miss Safiranya? Senang dong ya?
Seru.
Mau main games dulu nggak sebelum kita tutup? Mau nggak? Ini gamesnya seru banget loh, namanya Memory Test. Siapa yang suka lupa di sini? Ada nggak yang suka pelupa di sini? Nah, tapi kalau
Jocelyn
suka lupa. Nah, so this is only simple test. Jadi caranya gini, Kak Yudi bakal kasih kamu gambar, kamu cukup perhatiin ya. Jangan sama sekali sempat ngelihat yang lain, cukup perhatiin gambarnya. Lalu kemudian nanti Kak Yudi akan pilih gambar mana yang tadi sudah, kalian akan pilih mana gambar yang tadi sudah keluar, mana yang belum. Nah, jadi perhatikan, waktu per gambarnya Kak Yudi akan munculin hanya dalam waktu 1 detik atau setengah detik per gambar. Oke? Caranya adalah perhatikan, karena memperhatikan saja itu sudah membuat kalian ingat materinya lebih dari 50%. Jadi tadi yang memperhatikan kelas pasti lebih dari 50% tahu. Kita buktikan dengan tes berikut ini ya. Perhatikan semuanya di layar, kita lihat gambar berikut ini.
A burger.
Diperhatiin, nanti Kak Yudi tanya, kira-kira gambar mana yang tadi udah muncul. Kalian akan pilih kanan atau kiri. Okay, so you will continue to see the pictures. Okay, bisa ingat berapa kira-kira? How many pictures that you remember? Don't know ya.
Nah, aku lupa semuanya.
Wait, but I believe if you watch it, you will remember. Answer this. Okay, answer this. Which one? The right one or the left one?
Burger.
Right one, it's correct. Okay, so you still remember, right? So continue. Which one? The right or left one?
The left.
Okay, it's correct. Now, which one? The right or the left one?
Power.
Left. That's good. And then which one? Right or left?
Right.
Mickey.
Right. That's it. It's the Mickey. Now, Which one? Right or left?
Left.
Yep, indeed. Oh, all of you remember it. It's surprising. If you we focus on the pictures and we focus on the slide, we will remember it. Now, continue. Which one?
Cat.
Right. You. I like cat. I have cat in my house. So do you have a cat in your house?
No. Yes.
This cat is cute, right? Now, which one? Right or left?
Right.
Oh, that's great.
Left.
Now, right or left?
Left.
That's correct. That's a rocket. Right or left?
Left.
Yeah, that's correct. Right or left?
Right.
That's the statue in the United States. Right or left?
Left.
Right or left?
Left.
The mie goreng. Who lapar ya lihat mie goreng? Then right or left?
Right.
Yes, correct. It's Stonehenge in UK. Now right or left? Did you remember? Do you are you sure, left?
Right.
That's
right.
The right, yeah. And then, which one? Left or right?
Right,
the cancer. Right. Now, left or right?
Left.
Yeah, that's the woman. Then, left or right?
Right.
Yeah, you remember. Right. Do you like to play this? It's called Biang Lala, right? Now, which one?
Yes.
Left.
Left or right?
Left.
Yeah. Then, left or right? The cars or the motorcycle?
Left.
Yeah, that's cool. And now, which one?
Left.
Who is it right? It's a Sule, right? It's a left, the Barbie, right? Now, okay. So, what I want to say that if we focus on the slide, focus on the teachers, and focus to what our teachers say, we will remember half, more than half. That's why we can remember more than 50%. Ya, kita ingatkan lebih dari 50% dari gambar-gambar tadi. Kenapa? Karena kita memperhatikan. Nah, Kak Yudi ingin sampaikan ke adik-adik bahwa di Easy English ini ada banyak program, Bapak dan Ibu juga yang mendampingi anak-anak yang ada di dalam Zoom meeting kali ini, kita bahwa memiliki Easy English ini memiliki berbagai macam program. Dan Kak Yudi mau lihat ini, ada bagaimana sih suasana kelas di Easy English nih yang sudah berjalan ya. Dengan kali ini nanti ada Kak Yudi kenalin, trenernya Kak Andre. Nah, coba kita lihat video ya dari suasana kelas adik-adik teman-teman sebelumnya di Easy English. Coba kita lihat.
That cloud, the other cloud.
Right.
It runs very fast, Arca. It's four-legged, it runs very fast. You ride it, humans ride it, they go to war with it.
The horse.
Yes, a horse, right? A horse. The number comes first. One large mountain ring, right?
And what would you like to have?
We would like to have a one blue raspberry regular size. Two Skittles.
Now, Matthew, do you like pizzas though? Do you like pizzas?
Yes, I love pizzas!
What kind of pizzas do you like? Sidewalk. Listen carefully. Sidewalk. It's not sidewalk. It's not walk. There is no L here. Sidewalk.
Okay, so that's the English class. Yang sudah berjalan sebelumnya. Dan di situ tadi ada Kak Andre, Kak Yudi ingin kenali juga selain Miss Safira, ada juga Kak Andre. Halo Kak Andre, boleh muncul di permukaan bersama adik-adik. Nah, Kak Andre ini mengajarkan program yang kita kenal dengan nama Phonics. Halo Kak Andre. So, Kak Andre, how are you today?
I'm doing very fine. Thank
well,
you.
Very fine. So, how you look at all the participants in this afternoon?
Oh, they're doing great. All of them are very enthusiastic. So nice to meet all of you, by the way.
Okay, so thank you, Kak Andre. And then, kenapa sih pilih Easy English? Jadi Easy English ini dirancang dengan metode yang kreatif. Jadi Bapak dan Ibu yang sekarang ada di sampingnya adik-adik, boleh nih habis ini ikut, kalau tertarik ingin ikut sertakan anaknya belajar bahasa Inggris dengan cara yang menyenangkan, bisa di Easy English. Programnya apa saja sih? Jadi selain sebelum ke program, kita ngelihat kenapa sih kita belajar bahasa Inggris. Nah, buat kalian yang mau kuliah nanti di luar, kalian perlu bahasa Inggris. Sekolah juga perlu bahasa Inggris. Ya. Dan kenapa sih pilih Easy Trainer berpengalaman? Kak Andre juga dulu 12 tahun di Amerika Serikat ya, Kak Andre, ya, di tempat yang ada patung Liberty-nya. Nah, di dekat situ ya. So, Kak Andre, Kak Yudi mau nanya, itu patung Liberty nggak capek ya megangin obor terus ya setiap hari?
Enggak, kadang-kadang saya bantuin soalnya Kak Yudi.
So Kak Andre is help the Liberty statue.
Yeah, help him.
Okay. Nah, dan kemudian banyak banget sih orang yang sudah menguasai bahasa Inggris. Terus kenapa tidak adik-adik juga bisa menguasai bahasa Inggris sehingga nanti di masa depan kalian akan menjadi orang-orang yang bakal bisa menguasai ataupun memimpin bangsa ini karena memiliki komunikasi yang baik lewat bahasa Inggris. Nah, program kita itu ada English Conversation Class, ini buat yang mau memperlancar cara bicaranya. Lalu kalau mau memperlancar cara pengucapannya, Phonics Class. Nah, ini Phonics Class ada diajar Kak Andre, juga nanti dibantu sama Miss Safira. Nah, kalau Kak Andre, Kak Yudi mau nanya dulu, kalau how we say terima kasih di dalam, I will ask, want to be, siapa yang mau volunteer sih? Bilang
thank you.
Okay, so Mr. Andre, harusnya kalau bilang terima kasih apa sih? Bagaimana sih cara pengucapannya?
Okay, so actually in English you will say thank you. Right. So, what you guys need to watch is not tank, because tank is the machine that you guys go to war.
Do you know tank?
You know, thank
buat perang. Thank you. So yeah, how we should say it, Mr. Andre?
It's actually thank. The TH sound is th. Thank.
Thank you.
Thank. So you guys cannot say thank.
Okay. So, yeah. We will learn a little bit just with the phonics. Jadi kalau dari phonics aja kita udah tahu nih cara pengucapan yang benar, gimana sih nanti bahasa Inggris kita supaya native juga bisa tahu kita ngucapin yang benar gimana. Selain itu ada kelas fun grammar class sama Kak Safira, ada cerita-cerita SpongeBob, mungkin nanti ada cerita Marvel, mungkin ada cerita Iron Man, ya, banyak sekali ya. Thematic class, ada creative English buat kalian yang pengen belajar bahasa Inggris lebih lancar lagi. Kalau sibuk banget, mami kalian atau papa kurang lebih belum lancar juga bahasa Inggrisnya, mau belajar bahasa Inggris tapi nggak punya waktu, ada English by phone ya, jadi bisa ditelepon lalu cuma ngobrol bahasa Inggris, itu bisa juga belajar bikin esai. Dan buat yang mau kuliah, buat abang dan kakaknya yang mau kuliah di luar negeri, persiapan kuliah negeri, ada TOEFL dan IELTS preparation oleh tim TOEFL kita. Nah, jadi di Easy English ini lengkap banget programnya. Jadi selain daripada kelasnya yang mempelajarkan materi-materi yang penting dalam bahasa Inggris, kita juga menggunakan metode belajar yang kreatif ya dan efektif lewat kuis, games ya, video kayak tadi, banyak kuis ya, dan tentunya menjadi program pilihan dengan harga yang sangat terjangkau. Ini perbandingannya kalau Bapak dan Ibu yang ada di samping kanan kiri dari adik-adik ya, kalau di Easy English di sebelah sini mulai programnya ada yang 100.000, ada macam-macam, ada yang 100, 300, 400. Tapi kalau kita ke program lain ya, ada perbandingannya, harga per bulannya cukup berbeda. Pertemuannya juga 1-3 kali seminggu, fleksibel waktu 15-60, jumlah muridnya juga cukup sedikit, hanya 1-4 orang per kelas. Jadi semuanya betul-betul diperhatikan oleh gurunya. Kalau trial class kita ramean, tapi kalau kelas hanya 1-4 orang. Oke, nah itu yang mau Kak Yudi sampaikan. Ada program-programnya tadi, kalian bisa kontak ke nomor yang ada, dan juga ada program yang 100.000 yang cuma 4 pertemuan tiap bulan, itu juga ada. Yang ini khususnya buat yang dewasa, buat yang nggak punya waktu lagi tapi mau tetap merasa bahasa Inggris, bisa juga ikut program yang ini. Dan paling dekat buat kalian yang suka spelling bee, siapa yang sudah pernah ikut lomba spelling bee?
Ada
Oke, so we will have spelling bee competition with machine on 22 and 23 May. Jadi kita tandingnya antar 4 negara tambah satu lagi negara. 5 negara, Algeria, Indonesia, Filipina, Malaysia. Okay. Yes, that's if you interested, later you can join our program. Now, if you like to join the Easy English program, mau ikut grammar class yang tadi kayak sama Safira, mau ikut phonics class sama Mr. Andre, atau mau ikut kelas-kelas kita yang lain, nah silakan kontak ke nomor di sini, ada nama Kak Melinda. So, I would like to invite Miss Melinda. Are you here, Miss Melinda? Nah, Miss Melinda juga bisa bantu, dan ada juga Miss Widya ya. Jadi ada ke nomor ini dan bisa kontak ke nomor ini untuk bergabung. Program-programnya apa saja? Ini tadi ya, program-programnya ada dari English Conversation, Phonics, Fun Grammar, hingga IELTS dan TOEFL. Nah, itu dia yang mau Kak Yudi sampaikan di kali ini. Semoga kalian have fun today dan bisa belajar dengan yang menyenangkan. Dengan Easy English, kita bisa memperlancar bahasa Inggris dengan mudah dengan cara yang pastinya menyenangkan dan adik-adik pasti bakal terus ingin belajar lebih lanjut. Nah, itu aja yang mau Kak Yudi sampaikan. Kurang lebihnya Kak Yudi mohon maaf. Dan Kak Yudi kembalikan lagi kepada MC kita, Kak Erik Bobia. Silakan Kak Erik.
Terima kasih Kak Yudi Lesmana. Jadi gimana teman-teman, seru-seru kan pelajar-pelajar di Easy English, nggak cuma grammar, tapi ada tadi dengan Kak Andri juga untuk belajar phonics. Jadi kalau misalkan memang adik-adik, teman-teman tertarik, tinggal bilang nih ke ayah bunda untuk kontak ke admin Easy English yang mengajak adik-adik trial di hari ini. Nanti ayah bunda, adik-adik bisa tanya-tanya ke Kak Widya ataupun ke Kak Melinda untuk program-program kita. Nah, tadi juga dari kita sudah melihat ada beberapa teman-teman adik-adik yang berhasil menjawab dengan benar. Ya Kak Safira ya, ada beberapa nih teman-teman menjawab dengan benar dan akan mendapatkan hadiah khusus nih dari Easy English yang akan dihubungi kembali oleh Kak Melinda ataupun Kak Widya. Jadi selamat ya teman-teman yang sudah berhasil dan aktif mengikuti trial class Easy English. Oke? Segitu aja dari kami, dari tim Easy English. Nanti jika ayah bunda, adik-adik ada pertanyaan lagi, bisa menghubungi admin kita yang menghubungi teman-teman yang bisa mengikuti hari ini. Nah, ditunggu aja ya, Jocelyn. Kita ada hadiah spesial nih. Ditunggu kabarnya.
So you will have get vouchers.
Also. Yeah, special voucher.
And also, if you have all correct, maybe it's fun and you live in Jakarta, maybe we can send some chocolates ya, Kak Erik. Kalau di Jakarta,
maybe we can,
but if you came from Papua, we cannot send, okay?
Yeah, but, we will give you special prize for the winners, okay?
Okay,
mungkin seperti itu, Kak Yudi, Kak Safira, thank you, Kak Andre. Terima kasih banyak teman-teman, ayah bunda yang sudah ikut ke Trial Easy English hari ini. Selamat beraktivitas, semoga hari ini terus menyenangkan, dan semoga materi yang dibawakan Kak Safir bermanfaat untuk adik-adik sekalian. Oke, okay, bye-bye teman-teman.
Thank you so
Terima kasih, thank you semua.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you.